So one of those developers you've probably never heard of is a Japanese developer called Falcom. Now you may have not heard of them, but they make some of the best playing and also some of the best story-driven games out there. They also have these amazing, amazing soundtracks. And this year, they've released, I think, maybe one of the best games of 2017, Yeast 8 Lacrimosa Vena. But for the sake of just all this easiness, we're going to call it Yeast 8. Shane, you also like Falcom. What do you think of Yeast 8?
I also like Falcom. They're one of my favorite developers. So I may be a little bit like, what's the word? I can't really remember, but maybe like not great for this review because it's not going to be like objective. This is a subjective review. I love this game and it's so freaking great. The gameplay itself is basically like a hack and slash game where you're just killing a heap of enemies. It's still an action RPG style, so you're still leveling up, you're still getting items and stuff. But the great thing about this game is just like the momentum, the amount that you can just do with this game and just make it feel right.
Like, I think that's the thing we also, I totally agree on that, where basically the idea is there's just a really great sense of feel, a really great sense of momentum where you're just dodging and countering attacks. Like, you get a really good dodge, you get a really good counter, you go far, you jump far, and it feels really good. It doesn't feel like it breaks anything or any weird animation stuff like that. It just feels right.
That's the thing about this game. It feels really, really well, and it actually looks really pretty too. Like, when you actually get up onto the summit, there's a big mountain that you can climb, and get up onto the summit and looking down and everything, man, this game looks pretty. It's maybe not the most prettiest PS4 game itself.
It's got a style.
It's got its style, and it hits that style really, really, really well.
Yeah, like, just, and it's one of those games where, compared to other games in the series, and for the record, even though this is the eighth game in a series that's been around for 30 years, you really don't need to have played any of the other games in the series. You just dive right in, see the adventures of cool redhead adventurer Adel Christian, and he's just killing enemies like a monster.
Like, it's one of those games that you can jump in from any part of the story. There's still a few throwbacks, like even not knowing who the character Dogi is, but like, it's even then, it's such a great game to just jump into and play just because it feels really, really well. And the other great thing about this game...
Yes?
Soundtrack.
Oh, like, my God. It's so good.
Like, it's just so freaking spot on. Like, there's a lot of variation in sound, a lot of, like, different even genres in itself. There's one night track that's basically an EDM track that makes you feel really, really hyper, and but then you're also stealthing through, so it's a real like fusion of like, I really want to really do something fast in this track, but I'm supposed to go slow. It's really, really, I don't know, it works.
Yeah.
And then like just the, like one of the first songs you hear as you like wake up on the beach because you get kicked off of the ship and stuff, like it's such a great like uplifting like adventure track. Oh man, this whole game I just fucking love.
Yeah, I am a fan as well. I don't know if there's much more we can say about it. Like, if you like yourselves a good, unique action RPG, it's out on PS4, it's out on Vita, it's out on PC. Go check it out. It is really, if you're after something that no one else is really going to play this year, do yourself a favor, check it out. You're going to just fawn over it like we are.